Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Corey Dan, and in today's video, I would like to talk with you with the struggles you face as a coach or trainer to price properly your services in order to get satisfying clients, but at the same time, get a satisfaction yourself with the revenue you generate. So let's get started. Many coaches and consultants, many people who train other people in different matters in offline world, like sport coaches, like piano teachers, like language teachers, like any kind of coaches who sell their services on a personal level, one-on-one to their clients, struggling to properly structure the price of their services. And with that said, let me explain you how you can get the best level, not too high to not get anybody inside your coaching business, and not get too low to feel desperate about your monthly expenses or not feeling enough satisfied with your business. So, you have to know that you are worthy a lot more than you are currently selling in 99% of the cases. Yes, you heard that right. If you are struggling to price your services, most probably you are underpricing. Most probably you are pricing your services way too low. And I can remember this from my mother, who is a math teacher and who in the past tried to teach few students offline for their math exams, but she think that she don't want to took money from their parents, from these students. So she priced her hourly rate for this teaching so low that it was totally unworthy doing this, and she realized in few months and she stopped. So it was really a not pleasant experience to see my mother struggling to really price properly the highly valuable services, because she was excellent math teacher and she really helped these small children to get their student exams, to move to the next grade, and so on and so forth. So most of you are underpricing your services. Even if you are asking for a few hundred dollars for your services, I'm absolutely sure 99% of the time you really deliver more than you get as an exchange of value. And always, every single transaction, online or offline, is exchange of value. The value you provide must be equal to the value the persons bring you back in the form of money. And this equality should be done properly at the moment of transactions. Maybe in the future, the benefit for the client may be much higher and she or he may have tremendous results of your coaching and they get much higher value than what they pay you. But at the moment, they have to feel that the transaction is fair, is equal, and you personally have to feel the same way. You also have to feel that the transaction is fair and that the money they pay you is exactly what your time, what your effort, and what your expertise is worth to deliver them results. If you are getting clients for less than you are worthy, then you don't feel good and you are not motivated enough to bring them the best of the best of the best of yourself. Let's say, I think you understand what this problem is. And most of the time, the problems came back down to one simple fact, and it is we as a coaches, teachers and trainers lack the necessary confidence in ourselves, lack the confidence to sell with confidence, lack the confidence to really position ourselves as experts and say, this is what we bring to the table. This is what we expect as a price. And if the person is not right to, is not prepared to pay this price, then you don't have to worry. You don't have to think you are not worthy enough. Just this person is not your client. It's not the person who are meant to be your client and who are meant to really create the legacy in their life, to create the results they want. Why? Because they are not ready to get to the equal value exchange. If the person is staying on the frequency as low and they are struggling with getting finance, they are struggling, they are afraid to reach your level, then they are not worthy. But there are ways that you can change this without just disproving this person. Of course, it's good to have a pre-qualifying questionnaire, and I'm highly advising all of our clients inside the Aurora Spot Coaching Accelerator to have a pre-qualifying questionnaires with few questions to ask your leads who want potentially to work with you, to ask them and to be sure at the beginning that they are the right leads and to disqualify them. For example, if they fall in specific buckets which you don't want to work with. But there is a way that you can improve the chances of creating an equal, both sides satisfied transaction. And this is to overcome the fears and overcome the the unsurety, the lack of confidence in your potential client to work with you. And in order to do this, you have to bring to your sales call the best of your best, the best motivation and the best confidence. The one thing that is not something you will learn in the courses for becoming sales master, becoming high ticket closer and so and other stupid things is your gut feeling that you are worthy enough. Your inner enthusiasm and your full confidence in your ability to help is something that you feel inside you, and this is something that you don't need to train. You just have to feel it, and you feel it if you really, really deliver results. If you already have few clients with great results, you are worthy enough to feel very confident and to feel you are highly worthy of doing this service for other people. And this is something that they feel, they smell, they see in your eyes, they listen from your timbre of voice, for example, and they understand immediately. This is just a simple click inside the minds of your prospects. And this is something that they feel. But in order to make this magic happen, you have to convince yourself on 100% level that you are worthy enough and that you really want to work. If you are not enthusiastic enough, then the sales call become really difficult to happen. And but if you are enthusiastic, then it's very easy to overcome all different kind of objections. You don't have to be prepared for all the objections. You just have to be enthusiastic and confident in yourself, and your mind will find the proper way to remove the objections, to handle this kind of uncertainty in the minds of your prospects, and to close them as clients. There is one misconception in most wannabe coaches or just starting coaches that you can close your prospects without doing an actual sales call. For example, let's imagine you are a martial arts teacher in an offline space. You have a room, you have a place where you teach, for example, people different age martial arts. How do you sell your services? Somebody enter your door, knock, knock, open, enter, meet you, handshake with them, saying you nice to meet you. I'm XYZ. I'm pleased to meet you. I want to work with you. What is the price for 1 month of training? What is the price for one training? Can I test drive? Can I see how it works? This is actually one-on-one in real life offline situations where you are selling your services. So this is absolutely the same as doing an online sales call. You have to have an eye contact with your prospect. You have to talk with them on the phone line. Doesn't matter if it's Skype, Zoom, or other platform you know. I don't like Microsoft Teams, but some people want to make the meetings there. So in order to make the actual transactions, you need these sales calls. You cannot skip this step. Some people believe they can make automated webinars working for their courses. Yes, this is good. Many marketers are doing, but you don't know exactly what their traffic source is and how many people are bringing through this traffic into their landing page to capture their emails and to go to the auto webinars and to blast tons of emails to bring them again to auto webinars. So you don't know the numbers, and doing an automated webinar is not possible unless you have hundreds of thousands of people as a traffic source to push into this auto webinar page. So you cannot sell high paying coaching services on auto webinar. In rare occasions, if you have great experience, you can transition into this semi-automated or automated route. Later on, get automated or live webinars, but not in the beginning. You can sell with video sales letters, some cheap courses, some cheap products. You can you can do whatever you want, but you cannot do the proper exchange of energy, let's say, and proper meeting the value criteria of both of you unless you are on a sales call. So this is a huge misconception which many coaches believe, that they can skip these steps. No, you cannot skip the sales call, and you have to be 100% confident, and you have to know exactly what to say, and you have to bring all your enthusiasm, to bring all your magic into the sales call. And it is really magic. If you really enter a sales call with confidence and explain brilliantly how you will change the life of your prospects from their point A to their final dream desired destinations, how this process will look like, what you are bringing to the table, then it's much, much easier. And I can say it is the only possible way to close high ticket sales. And some people say, oh, this is fake. You cannot charge 5K for a 1 month coaching. It's impossible. You cannot charge 10K. How on the earth somebody will pay 10K for someone to teach them on the phone online? But it's not true that this is impossible. It's totally possible, and it's doable with the proper energy, and with eye contact, with a real talk with these persons. If you convince them properly that you are worthy this price, they will be happy to pay. And I can assure you that they will be also your best clients, because at the beginning of your connection between each other, the proper energy level is set up high enough that the vibration of this energy will continue to persist throughout the entire coaching sessions, throughout the entire coaching process you will have. This will be your best clients. They will have least resistance to learn. They will get the best results, and they will be always satisfied and will not want to refund. Most often the people who refund are people who have initial disconnect between what they believe they should pay and get and what you believe you should deliver and pay. If there is some kind of disharmony between your visions during the sales call, if they believe that they should not pay enough, but you force them with forcing tactics, which I am highly advising not to use. You are not on the sales call to force people to join. You are there just to invite them in the proper manner. And if they are not ready to get to the same level, you don't switch, you don't turn around, you just say, thank you very much for your time. We can meet again in the future when you are ready, but you are not at this present moment. Handshake and goodbye. This is the way you do sales calls. You don't over-expect from people. You don't push them. You don't make them feel overwhelmed by your pushiness. You just present with confidence what you are giving and what you are asking. And if the resonating vibe is happening, then you have best clients who are happily paying you for this kind of services. Only if there is not the perfect resonance and you force these people to enter, if you grab them and say, listen, you have to enter into my program because X, Y, Z, I will give you everything, but listen to me. I will give you 50% discounts, but I want you inside my program. These people will see the discounts, see that you are ready to to give your guard back. They will pay you the lower price. They will enter and they will not be satisfied. They will refund. So this is the moment that is not good for your business. When you are pushing too strong for people who are not ready, then you get unsatisfied clients who are paying in the ass. So with that said, let's debrief. Let's summarize what I really wanted to show you and to emphasize you here. First of all, you are worthy your knowledge, your experience, your teaching methodologies. You are worthy all of this, and you have to be ready to articulate your price with your prospects. You have to be ready to talk with confidence on the sales call, and you have to be ready to take lightly with a smile the answer that will be no. Even if you have 100 sales calls and 99 of them says no, this is not a problem. You have one high paying client out of 100. And this is a worst case scenario. I never saw a coach that needed 100 sales calls to get their first high paying clients. Never in my more than 4 years personal experience working with people. So you have to be ready to take the no answer. You have to be ready to work with confidence on these sales calls. You have to know that there is no other way around to bring the people without doing sales calls. So this is crucial. You have to really bring all your energy, all your enthusiasm, all your know-how, expertise, and make your prospects feel the same enthusiasm as you do. When you get this magic happen, you will get successful enrolling over and over again. And you will be highly surprised how much people are ready to spend in order to solve their pain. People are really ready to spend a lot to solve fast and efficient their problems. They are just not sure if you are the right coach, the right trainer or teacher to make this transformation. When you remove this uncertainty, when you remove these obstacles inside the minds of your prospects, they are ready to pay you on the second. And I know a lot of highly successful coaches really have hundreds of prospects with their open wallet just asking where to pay you, where to send the money, where. And this is because these coaches know exactly very well how to articulate and how to talk on sales calls. And of course, when you master doing this, you can move into live webinars. And when you master the live webinars and have enough money to spend on traffic, you can do automated webinars. But most often, automated webinars are the best of the best of the live webinars, and the live webinars are the actual emanation, the best of the best of your real example sales calls. So this is the ladder you have to climb in order to be qualified to test drive automated webinars. You have to start with sales calls, then you have to move to live webinars or Facebook Lives, and only then to move to automated webinars. So don't think about automating the sales process unless you become a master of the sales call. And the one thing I want you to take out of this training is just feel confident that you are worthy enough for high ticket service to your client. That's it. Simple, very effective, and very satisfying when you really see it working in a real life example. Thank you very much for watching. Click the subscribe button and like this video if you want to see more of our trainings. Bye-bye.